All right. Now that you guys have a few of the basic chords down and a couple of songs under your belt, let's take a look at some more advanced chords, some chords that we'll actually use in some popular songs later on in the video series. Let's do a little zoom in and I'll show those to you right now. All right, let's get started with these chords. The first one we want to learn is D. There's a couple of ways we can do D. The first way is with your first finger on the second fret of fourth string, and middle finger on the third string, and third finger on the second string. Those are all going to be on the second fret. And here's what it sounds like. All right, now some people think that's really tight little area to get all three fingers in there, so you could actually do this. You could swap the middle finger and the first finger, and this actually alleviates a little bit of the cramped area there. And then the other way to do the chord would be by barring your finger across three strings. Now this one takes a little bit of hyperextension. A hyperextension is where your finger kind of bends back this way, and you're going to do that exact thing like that so that you leave that first string open, and it'll still sound the same. Most people can't do this, so I would choose one of the other ways if you can't do this. All right, that's going to be your D chord. And then here's a little chart for it right there. Okay, so the D7 is another chord that we should do. There's two ways to do this one. We could do it with the middle finger on the fourth string and then the third finger on the second string. It sounds like this. And if you wanted to, you could use this fingering as well, the one and the two. And if you wanted to add the third finger in there, that's another version of D7. Just get a higher seventh note there. All right. Another very common chord is a G7. And you'll notice we're doing all these seven notes. So every chord has a seventh that could go along with it. This is going to be G7. So first finger on the second string, first fret, middle finger on the second fret of the third string, and then your third finger will be on the first string, second fret. So it's kind of like a mirrored opposite of your G chord, if you remember that G chord. And this sounds like this. And there you go. All four strings on that one as well. Now C7 is simple. It's just your first finger on the first fret of the first string. It's a nice sounding chord. All right, now if you go to your F chord, first finger, second string, first fret, and your middle finger, second fret of the fourth string. To get to F7, all you have to do is add your third finger to fret three of string three. It sounds like this. Something else you can do to extend this chord is add the little finger to the first string, and it should sound like this. Now, whenever you add a finger, or you have four fingers on four strings, you can actually move the chord. So if I play this as a F7, I can move it up to here. This would be called a F#7, and then you get a G7, and then a G#7, and so on. So anytime you don't have an open note, you can move the chords. Okay? All right, moving on. E minor. This is going to be one that we use in Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Okay, so this one looks like this. First finger, second fret of first string, second finger, third fret, and then third finger is going to be on the fourth fret. And you can strum all four strings. Now, some people might do this. They might put the third finger on the fourth fret of string four and then the little finger underneath there. This one's a little more difficult, but then it makes it movable, so I could go E minor, F minor, F sharp, and so on. But we'll just stick with this easy version, 1, 2, and 3. And let's do an A chord now. An A chord looks like this. First finger, first fret, string three, and then the middle finger will be on string four, fret two. And now if you want to make that chord into an A7, it's very simple. All you do is lift up the middle finger, leaving the fourth string open, and you get an A7 chord. All right, let's do an E7 chord. The E7 chord looks like this. First finger, first fret of string four, then the middle finger goes on string three of fret two, and then your third finger will be on the first string, second fret. And this one sounds like this. That's an E7 chord. We'll use that one as well. All right, The final chord I want to show you is the more of the difficult chords. This one's going to be called B flat. And the reason it's hard is because you have to press two strings with one finger. And you may even start out by practicing this with just the first finger, squeezing the first and second string. And then just see if you can get those two to sound like this. That's a good squeeze. You're pinching really hard to get that. Not really the death grip, but just hard enough so that the fingers are pressing firmly against the fret. And then you're going to reach your middle finger and arch it over the first and second strings on the second fret, third string there. And then the third finger will reach to the fourth string, third fret. So if you got this finger nudged down a little bit, you're going to get it. And I tell some of my students that if you lean to the left a little bit, like instead of having your fingers perpendicular to the fretboard, lean it to the left, and that's going to help you leverage and bar the first fret a little bit easier. This one should sound like this. All right. And because we have no open notes here, this is a movable chord. B flat would be the first fret, and then B. If you move one more fret to the third fret, you get another C, and a C sharp, and a D. Okay? It's going to take you a little practice getting that bar down, but if you keep trying, you'll get it. All right. So try to memorize all these chords that we've learned, and then we'll be able to use them in songs.